Hello, my friends. My name is Sam, aka Sir_Beardface. Today, you're watching Sam the Vlog, and we will be discussing the secret of the kitchen whisk and what it means for you and your photography future. Stay tuned. Before we begin, guys, please go follow me on Instagram where you can see all of my photography. This video is photography related. It makes sense that you would go see what kind of photography I'm producing out of my camera. So today we're talking about steel wool, long exposure photography, how, what, why, when, and where you should be doing this, and what it'll mean for your portfolio. If you're a budding photographer or even an experienced photographer who's never played around with this before, it is a must at least one time in your life. It comes up with the coolest images you could ever imagine, and you just gotta try it. You gotta know how to do it so you can talk about how to do it and tell other people how to do it. Check out my Instagram. People were asking me up and down, how did you take that photo? What did you do? I wanna do this, so cool. I just did what I saw other people doing, and I'm gonna show you how to do it so you can go do it. Pass along the love. So here we go, let's talk about this. This is steel wool photography. First, I'm gonna tell you exactly what you need to make this happen and exactly what we use to make this image happen. Number one, it's steel wool. If you don't know what that is, it's this stuff. It's a little wiry, scratchy pad of metal that happens to be flammable. I bought mine at Walmart. You wanna buy the fine grade steel wool. It's very thin, fine, and it's just nice for what we're doing. You're also gonna need a kitchen whisk. What's a whisk? It's this thing. Go buy them at Walmart, buy a small stainless steel metal one for like $3. They're cheap. You need two more things. Either a piece of rope or some kind of lanyard to attach to the whisk. We used a piece of rope and we just tied it off to the little hook at the end of the whisk, and we were solid. Warning, by spinning the rope around so many times, I put a massive blister into my hand. So maybe find something that's a little bit more practical. Lastly, you need a lighter or a match, something to light the steel wool on fire. And of course, I'm gonna assume you already have a tripod and you have a camera. That's it. You can go and do this and get this started for under $10, and you can be out making these beautiful, crazy photos. So what's really happening here? Let's break down what's going on in a photo like this. First of all, this is a long exposure photograph, so you're gonna want your camera on a tripod. Tripod eliminates all the shake from your hand, and if you have your shutter open for a long period of time, there's no way to hand hold that shot without getting all kinds of blur and junk, and your photo's gonna look like trash. So get yourself a tripod, slap your camera on top of it, set your shutter up for about a 10 second exposure to start. You can adjust the settings as you go, and obviously it's gonna depend on where you're shooting. I did an 8 to 10 second exposure and found that this was the perfect amount of time that allowed for not too many sparks, not too few sparks, just enough sparks. My dog just moved back there and scared the crap out of me. I have to give you guys a warning here that yes, you're dealing with fire. Please do this in a safe area. Don't go in an open field of brittle, dry brush and grass that's gonna light the place ablaze. Smokey the Bear would be ticked, and you're gonna end up in the bunker if you light a freaking forest fire. In our case, we were on a ranch in Texas with our good friends David and Catherine. We were camping out there, and we set this up in a giant open field with no grass, just dirt, and it worked fantastically. Here's a pro tip. I like to set the camera to a 2 to 10 second timer before it releases the shutter so that you can eliminate and get away from the tripod, give yourself a little time. So that's all you do is you pack the little whisk, you take the whisk, you pack it full of that steel wool, use a little bit in the end, light that thing, hit the shutter, and start spinning around in whatever kinds of circles. As soon as the steel wool's lit, little sparks and embers fly off in all kinds of crazy directions. Your camera is there to capture every single little piece of light, and it results in some pretty awesome photos. As far as the editing goes, it's pretty simple, and I can walk you through my Lightroom here and how I tweaked this photo and show you the before and after. All right, guys, so here we are in Lightroom. Here's the original photo, totally unedited. I'm gonna go briefly through my workflow in Lightroom and just show you a few of the quick edits that I made to get the final result of this photograph. So before I do anything, I always come down here to lens corrections. I remove chromatic aberrations. If you don't know what those are, that's when you get like weird purple and green ghosting around fine lines in your photograph. And then I also enable profile corrections, which will flatten out the image and get rid of any vignetting or kind of lens distortion that comes with that lens. I always do that to start. Now, with this photo, right off the bat, I know I don't like the crop, so I'm gonna change that up a little bit. There's too much foreground up here, and I wanna focus that in on the two of us here as the subject.
So I'm just gonna hit the crop button, bring that in to somewhere around there, and then of course, utilize the rule of thirds, place myself right there on that cross point, and hit enter. Boom, so that's pretty close to where I want it. So right away, there's a few things going on that I wanna change. There's a lot of highlights here that are a little bit blown out, and I wanna just back that down a little bit. So I'm gonna tone the exposure down a touch. I'm also gonna back the highlights off just a little bit, which helps define each one of those lines and those sparks. Now, a lot of times you'll pump the shadows in images, but in this case, I don't want any focus on the foreground or any of this brush back here in the background. So I'm gonna take the shadows all the way down and get rid of all that excess stuff in the background. The temperature, I've already adjusted, I should have shown you that, but from the beginning was way, way, way too orange. So I took that down quite a ways to cool that off. I don't want them quite white. I want them kind of a nice orange glow. So right about there, but not flooding the image with that warmth. Sometimes I mess with clarity, but this image is pretty sharp, so I'm not gonna touch that too much. Maybe I'll sharpen on export for the screen, but that's maybe just about 10 right there, and that's about it. I'm not messing with the whites or blacks in this one here, and so this is where a lot of the magic happens. What I usually do is drop 2 points. It's a very common S-curve, which is gonna bring in a little bit more contrast, pump the highlights just a little bit, and then of course, flatten these shadows, which gives it kind of that moody look. You just grab that bottom point there and slide it up the left side. Obviously, you don't want to go too far because you're going to end up with some weird, funky weirdness. Just give that a little touch to kind of blow out the shadows there and flatten that image in the back and really focus in on the subject. Now, it looks subtle right here, but if you go turn that off, turn that on, you can see the difference that makes. Kind of makes it a little bit moody. And my phone is ringing, cool. Now, one of the other things I wanna do is there's still kind of an overall yellowness to this, so you can go into the hue, saturation, and luminance tab and just play around with a few of these. And that's one thing to keep in mind in Lightroom. There's no science to any of this stuff. It is literally, okay, there is a little science, but for the most part, how I learned Lightroom was just playing with every one of these sliders until I figured out kind of a workflow that I like in Lightroom here. So get in here and just play around with it a little bit, and you'll quickly find that you know your way around. So maybe I'll desaturate the yellows. A lot of the times I'll take that all the way down just to see what it looks like, and it turns out it's more oranges than yellows. So take that down maybe just a touch to back off some of that yellowy warmness. Now, one of the other things I believe I did on the original edit was grabbed a gradient and drag that up from the bottom, and I drop the exposure down here just a little bit because I just don't want your eyes going to the foreground. I like the glow around here, but I don't want any detail in the front here. I want all of the focus to be right here. Now, one of the other things I always do is I come into detail and I sharpen up to about 70 max. I don't want it to be over sharp. And then I also take the radius down to the smallest 0.5. That just helps smooth it out a little bit so you're not so detailed and sharp in here where it looks weird. And then as far as noise reduction goes, I'll usually bump that up to about 30, which again will help smooth out any kind of noise that your photo picked out. Again, play with this. It's different on every photo, on every exposure. And then if you were to go to the before and after here, before, and after, before, and after.
Guys, that's it for Steel Wool Photography. It's straight, simple, and cheap. Go and do it, go and try it, but be safe when you do it. It's a lot of fun and you're gonna end up with some cool images. If you take some and you wanna tag me in them, show me on Instagram, I will check them out and be sure to like them. It is fun, go enjoy. Thank you guys for watching. Please consider subscribing with the little red button below. We will see you on the next video. Adios.